romanticism, what romanticism is, because people or students sometimes are misguided by the word romanticism. So what is romanticism? Romanticism is a movement in the arts and literature that originated in the late 18th century, emphasizing inspiration, subjectivity, spontaneity, love for common people, and the primacy of the individual. It means the state or quality of being romantic. Romanticism is with a large pinch of realism. So romanticism is also known as the romantic era. So which was an artistic, literary, musical and intellectual movement that originated in Europe towards the end of the 18th century and in most areas was at its peak in the approximate period from 1800 to 1850, and somebody says 1840. So it depends on what the William J. Long says and what Albert book says and what is the so many David Deitch's book also there, the history of English literature. So there is a doubt in that. So romanticism is an addition of strangeness to beauty. What is it? It is an addition of strangeness to beauty. What are the characteristics of romanticism? I may ask you, write any five characteristics of romanticism. Interest in the common and common man and the childhood. Subjectivity, spontaneity, supernaturalism, love for common people, love for common language, love for nature, imagination, creativity, celebrations of individual, importance of imagination, then your liberty, equality. So many characteristics are there of romanticism. So romanticism, attitude or intellectual orientation that characterized many works of literature. It includes painting, music, architecture, criticism, and historiography in Western civilization over a period, which is already interacted. So, my dear students, now I would like to tell you about this romanticism, and you should be very careful about it. Please listen carefully, this romanticism. How this romanticism has been explained by different people. Now, the term romanticism means a tendency. What does it mean? The term romanticism means a tendency, feeling, principle, or spirit in search of a romance beyond the limits of ordinary life, सामान्य जीवन की सीमाओं से परे की जब बात की जाती है, अपने हृदय के मनोभावों की, अपने हृदय की फीलिंग की जब बात की जाती है, जो विचार दिल में रहते हैं लेकिन अनायास स्फुटित हो जाते हैं, अनायास उनका वो बाहर निकलना चाहते हैं, और जब वो बाहर निकलते हैं तो या तो कविता के रूप में लिखे जाते हैं या किसी और भाव से, कहानी के रूप में या किसी के रूप में जब वो लिख दिए जाते हैं, तो उसको कहते हैं स्पॉन्टेनियस ओवरफ्लो ऑफ पावरफुल फीलिंग. और यही है विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ की डेफिनेशन ऑफ पोएट्री. सो द टर्म रोमांटिसिज्म मीन्स ए टेंडेंसी, एक प्रवृत्ति है, एक फीलिंग है, प्रिंसिपल और स्पिरिट इन सर्च ऑफ रोमांस बियॉन्ड द लिमिट्स ऑफ व्हाट इज लाइफ. इट्स मेन एली इज इमेजिनेशन. व्हाट इज दैट? Imagination is the main characteristics. Its main ally is imagination, and it stresses the emotional side of human nature. The word romanticism has been derived from romance, which means something imaginative, which means something adventurous, which means something thrilling, which means something wonderful, something related with the superpower, supernaturalism, something related with subjective emotional feelings of an individual, something related with liberty. So that means the word romanticism has been derived from the word romance, which means something imaginative, adventurous, thrilling, subjective, spontaneous, supernatural, imaginative, creative, and wonderful. So in literature, the term came to mean a tendency, a principle. A tendency, a principle, an attitude. Remember, most important word. An attitude which insists upon something imaginative, something exciting, emotional, and wonderful. Now, if we go back to the Renaissance period, when you had been learning already in the first semester your loving interest or love means not to the marriage of true minds, and so many poems, and you'll be learning here also. In England, the term came into being during the early years of the Renaissance period. Punarjagran kal jo aapne sikha, Renaissance means love for beauty, love for power, love for knowledge. All these spirits or these emotions or these characteristics or these salient features were in Renaissance. In 1570, a number of Spanish romances also came. So now, these were translated into English. They excited the imagination of several English men of letters. Lilly, Sidney, Spencer composed great romances. Lilly's Euphues, 1580, Sidney's Arcadia, and great romances, Lilly's. All these people were writing during that period. So gradually, imagination came to be regarded as an essential element of literature. Imagination came to be regarded as an essential element of literature, particularly of poetry, then came in Shakespeare since 1519 to 1611, and he produced a number of plays and a large amount of the first-rate poetry. We'll be learning that as you like it later on. You'll find the wonderful play of William Shakespeare. We have already learned some of the sonnets. Since 1590 to 1611, he produced a number of plays and a large number of the first-rate poetry, and his plays, that means he has written 154 sonnets, and has sat romanticism on the throne of English poetry and drama. That means, my dear students, ki ye jo inka jo beej jo boya gaya tha, ye romanticism ka, ye beej kab boya gaya tha, kahan boya gaya tha, kaise boya gaya tha, to ye beej romanticism ka रिनेसा पीरियड में ही बो दिया गया था, और रिनेसा पीरियड में इस बीज को जब बोया गया तो उसी समय इसके बारे में ये सब बातें हुई। और अब आगे बढ़ता चला गया, 17 सेंचुरी में भी ये देखने को मिलता है। अब 17 सेंचुरी में क्या देखने को मिलता है? In the late first 60 of the 17th century, romanticism wrestled with classicism in English literature. Now, John Milton is the greatest poet of this period. You will be learning The Paradise Lost. Wonderful book. And this Paradise Lost book has inspired and motivated Swami Vivekananda. This book also inspired Mahatma Gandhi, because if you read the slogans of this book, where the John Milton is saying, fallen cherubs, to be weak is miserable, doing or suffering. So this slogan of John Milton, doing or suffering, which was written or published in 1688 by John Milton, Mahatma Gandhi gave it in 1946, Bharat Chodo Andolan ke samay, karo ya maro. So Mahatma Gandhi gave this slogan, doing or suffering, means doing or dying, karo ya maro. Mere deshvasiyo, ya to swatantrata praapt karo, ya phir maro. But this thing was already told with the inspiration and motivation taken from the Bible by John Milton in 1688. So John Milton is the greatest poet of this period. He was a follower of classicism. Poetry shook the, you know, the rattle of romanticism in 1660. Charles II has brought back from the France to made king of England, and the event is known as the Restoration. Since 1660 to 17, Romanticism in England. And the event is known as the Restoration period since 1660 to 1700. And Romanticism went on long vigor and Classicism went on gaining ground. In the 18th century also we find. The period from 1702 to 1740 is called the Classical Age in England. In the field of classical poetry, Alexander Pope was a central figure. After Pope, Classicism declining and lost all the vigor in 1770. So Romanticism gradually came to the force again. It was never uprooted from English literature. Even during the Classical Age, 1702 to 1740, there appeared romantic works. There was Thompson, and he wrote Seasons in 1727 or in 1730, Young's Night Thoughts, 1740 to 1745, and Richardson's novel, 1740, but the imagination of Wordsworth's Lyrical Ballad, 1798, announced the revival of Romanticism. But the publication of Wordsworth's Lyrical Ballad, publications of Wordsworth Lyrical Ballad announced the Romanticism. So this is the introduction, means just to introduce you about all the situations about the Romantic period. So the Romantic movement means strong general tendency towards Romanticism literature. Romantic movement. Romantic movement began in Germany in 1780s. Soon it was joined by a similar movement in France, where the beginning of the French Revolution 1789 released. I discussed already earlier, and it is also given in your notes, the notes which were sent to you. The great emotional forces. So that means Germany in 1780, soon it was joined by a similar movement in France where the beginning of French Revolution 1789 currents were already on the rise against the weak classical restraints. The awakening of English imagination had already begun. Its evidences were Macpherson's Ocean 1760, Percy's Relic 1765 and Walpole's Castles of Otranto, 1764. The pre-romantic poetry of Burns and William Blake is also romantic in spirit. William Blake, we have already discussed, but it is not in your syllabus. It is in first semester English General. The poem is The Lamb. Little Lamb, do you know who made thee? Who gave thee wool? Who gave thee wood? He says, Little Lamb, I will tell you. He is meek, he is timid, and he is also coward like you. He is God, he is Jesus Christ. That means now the lamb is the Jesus Christ, the lamb is William Blake, and the lamb is the child. So the wonderful poem, and that is full of imagination. Another poem is also there of William Blake, full of imagination. Ek bachcha hai jo badlon par baith kar jata hai. Aur wo bahut hi achhi kavita hai. So I will let you know that about later on. The Romantic Revival. So, my dear, remember, the pre-Romantic poetry of Burns and Blake is also romantic in spirit. So, when all these tendencies united in William Wordsworth and Samuel Taylor Coleridge, they published the Lyrical Ballads in 1798. So, who published the Lyrical Ballad? The Lyrical Ballads was published by William Wordsworth and Samuel Taylor Coleridge in collaboration. The word Romantic Revival. What is this Romantic Revival? This publications of the Lyrical Ballads. Please pay attention. This publication of the Lyrical Ballads described as the beginning of the Romantic Revival. The term Romantic Revival refers to the late 18th century and early 19th century. And your syllabus is 19th and 20th century history of English literature. So this is very important. You will find that the term Romantic Revival refers to the late 18th century and the early 19th century revolt against classicism or neoclassicism. Then revolt made a call jump over the classical restraints towards a more picturesque, original, free, and imaginative style. Kalpanatmak Shaili. Free, Swatantra, liberty. Remember, because 1789 America became free, and then what is democracy? Democracy is of the people, for the people, and by the people. And Dr. Babaram Swami enterprise of the student, for the students, and by the students. So then revolt made a call jump over the classical restraints towards a more picturesque, original, free and imaginative style in literature and art. And soon a romantic school of poetry came into being. The most famous poets of this school are William Wordsworth, Samuel Taylor Coleridge, Byron, Percy Bysshe Shelley and John Keats. Wonderful poets. You will be learning all this. John Keats or to Nightingale, you'll be learning. William Wordsworth, Chintan Abbey, you'll be learning. Now, my dear students, kya hua? Kaise hua? Aur kyon hua? Aur ye kya, kab aa gaya? Ye romanticism. Aur iski zarurat kya thi? Jab America swatantra ho gaya, to wahan Abraham Lincoln ne kya kaha? The democracies of the people, for the people and by the people. Aur liberty, swatantrata ki baat hone lagi. फ्रेंच रिवोल्यूशन आ गई. जिन्होंने इतिहास पढ़ा है दे नो इट बेटर. द आउटब्रस्ट ऑफ इमेजिनेटिव लिटरेचर. द रोमांटिक रिवाइवल कॉज्ड मोस्ट रिमार्केबल आउटब्रस्ट ऑफ इमेजिनेटिव लिटरेचर ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट 30 इयर्स ऑफ द 19th सेंचुरी. 19वीं शताब्दी के पहले 30 साल बहुत पावरफुल और बड़े शक्तिशाली साल थे, जिसमें कल्पना, क्रिएटिविटी, स्पॉन्टेनिटी, सब्जेक्टिविटी, love for common people. You know that very well. Thomas Gray has written a very good poem, an elegy written in a country churchyard. Aur is kavita se prerit hokar Lata Mangeshkar ne ek geet gaya. Ae mere watan ke logo jara aankh mein bhar lo pani, jo shaheed hue hain unki jara yaad karo qurbani. Aur Thomas Gray bhi wahan ye kehte hain ki aap raja ki, rani ki, वैरियर की, इनकी सबकी बात तो करते हो, सबके बारे में तो लिखते हो, कविताएं लिखते हो, गीत गाते हो, लेकिन उन गरीब किसानों के बारे में भी कुछ गीत गाओ, उन फौजियों के बारे में भी कुछ गीत गाओ, उन मजदूरों के बारे में भी जो गीत गाओ, जो बाहर अगरतला से बाहर भी जो खेतों में काम करते हैं, मजदूरी करते हैं और अपनी सब्जी बेचकर अपना गुजारा करते हैं, उन गरीब लोगों को भी याद करो जो समाज के, जो सोसाइटी के कंट्रीब्यूशन में, उनके उत्थान में बहुत बड़ा योगदान देते हैं. Wonderful poem, an elegy written in a country churchyard. You read this poem, you will enjoy. So in that poem, whatever the theme is there, the same theme has been brought by the lyricist, and he wrote a song, and that song was sung by Lata Mangeshkar. Ae mere watan ke logo jara aankh mein bhar lo pani, jo shaheed hue unki jara yaad karo qurbani. This is the period when the nationalism, patriotism, देशभक्ति और राष्ट्रवादिता की भावना इंग्लैंड में फिर से भर गई थी, बहुत ज्यादा रिनासेंस की तरह. और यहां विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ की कविता टू द स्काईलार्क, वो पूरे संसार में विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ फ्रांस में भी घूमते हैं, जर्मनी में भी घूमते हैं, सब जगह घूमते हैं, घूमने के बावजूद लेकिन उनकी नजर अपने देश पर ही रहती है. दैट मीन्स द स्काईलार्क कीप ऑन मूविंग थ्रू आउट इन द स्काई बट ऑलवेज लुक एट इट्स ऑन नेस्ट. सो माई डियर पीपल, माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अ वंडरफुल एज, यू मस्ट रीड एंड अंडरस्टैंड इट. The Romantic Revival caused a most remarkable outburst of imaginative literature during the first 30 years of the 19th century. The poetry and the prose of the first generations of the Romantic poets is marked by sincere emotion and a free play of imagination. Nature is looked upon a great source of beauty. To William Wordsworth, nature is a great source of spiritual power. To William Wordsworth, nature is a great source of spiritual power. William Wordsworth said that nature is God. Prakriti hi Paramatma hai. Prakriti bahut bada teacher hai. Wo kehte hai, nature is a teacher whose wisdom we can learn if we will and without which the human life is in vain and incomplete. Ye Prakriti Paramatma hai. Ye Prakriti ek shikshak hai. Ye nature hume bahut kuch sikhati hai. और मेरे प्यारे दोस्तों, आपने कहते तो त्रिपुरा में जो होजागिरी डांस है वो तो प्रकृति से भरा हुआ है. पूरा का पूरा एक्शन होजागिरी डांस का प्रकृति के बारे में बताता है, भूकंप के बारे में बताता है, पहाड़ी के बारे में बताता है, और जो जब वो क्या नाम है, ये हर चीज प्रकृति के हर एक्शन को होजागिरी डांस दिखाता है. सो दिस टू विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ, नेचर इज अ ग्रेट सोर्स ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल पावर. Nature is a teacher. Nature is God. The language of poetry is also made romantic under the impact of classicism and had become artificial and conventional. But English romanticism allowed the writers to use any kind of word suitable for their purpose. Imagery became striking, sensational and fresh. All kinds of meter, all forms of poetry, stories, novels were attempted. There seemed to be an atmosphere of general freedom in the domain of literature. And you know, we know very well, Sahitya Somaji Darpan. Literature is the mirror of society. Society is made of persons. Hum logo se milkar samaj bana hai. Society is made of persons, means the boy and the girl and the man and the women. And we are the bond of the personal traits, attitude. हमारी जो चारित्रिक विशेषता है उससे इंटरेस्ट एटीट्यूड वैल्यू से हमारा ये समाज बना है. सो मेरे प्यारे छात्र छात्राओं, अंडर द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ क्लासिसिज्म इट हैड बिकम आर्टिफिशियल एंड कन्वेंशनल बट इंग्लिश रोमांटिसिज्म अलाउड द राइटर्स टू यूज एनी काइंड ऑफ वर्ड्स suitable for the purpose. Imagery became striking, sensational and fresh. All kinds of meter, all forms of poetry, stories, novels were attempted. There seemed to be an atmosphere of general freedom, liberty, supernaturalism, spontaneity, love for common people, love for common language, love for poor people language. And it was not the language of the kings and the queens like William Shakespeare's language. It was a very simple language. And there seemed to be an atmosphere of general freedom in the domain of literature. In it, every artist was free to attempt any kind of literature under any kind of rule. Characteristics of romantic or English romanticism. Subjectivity, spontaneity, supernaturalism. Ecstasy, escapism, इस संसार से दूसरे संसार में जाना, जैसे रविनाथ टैगोर भी कहते हैं, into that heaven of freedom, oh my father, let my countrymen awake. Trade for imagination, create for imagination. Love for common people. Love for poor people. So, dear students, this period is the wonderful period. English Romanticism was a psychological force. What was it? It was a psychological force. English Romanticism was a psychological force. It opposed only the doctrine of classicism, but it adopted classical forms of poetry, classical myth. In practice, it rejected the classical doctrines of simple, humanitarian theme, conventional language, and poetic fancy. It also rejected the belief. That the heroic couplet was the best verse for form for poetry. It was a moment which inspired its followers to explore the whole universe for creating literature. It was an aesthetic creed of free imagination in every field. Creed of emotions. English Romanticism was a creed of emotions. Neoclassical poetry is devoid of emotion. There is in it better feeling of satire here and there. But romantic literature is built on or around an emotional experience in the poetry of William Wordsworth, H.T. Coleridge, Shelley and Keats. Emotion is the life of a poem. Emotion is the life of a poem. They seek emotion from nature. You also think, अगर आपके हृदय से इमोशन निकाल दिए जाएं, तो क्या कोई रिलेशन रहेगा? मम्मी पापा से कोई संबंध रहेगा? ना, सब कुछ खत्म हो जाएगा. इमोशन इज what they say? Emotion is the life of a poem. They seek emotion for nature, an event of the past, a myth, a personal experience, a longing, a desire, an intent, or whatever it is, or anything. Then they build up their literary creation around it. This is also true of prose. For example, Charles Lamb's essay Dream Children is built upon a longing of life which was written in 1822. Creed of self-expression. अगर आप अपने मन के भाव को नहीं कहेंगे, अपने मन की वाणी को नहीं कहेंगे, अपने मन की सोच को नहीं कहेंगे, अंदर ही अंदर रखेंगे, तो दुनिया फिर आपको समझेंगी नहीं और आप उनको नहीं समझेंगे. Creed of self-expression, खुद को एक्सप्रेस कीजिए. English Romanticism was a creed of the expressions of self. अहम ब्रह्मास्मि दैत्यनास्तु. अपने आप को समझिए, मैं कौन हूं, who am I, what am I, where am I, and what I have to do, and how I have to study. मुझे क्या करना है, कैसे पढ़ना है, कैसे लिखना है, और कैसे आगे बढ़ना है, और कैसे अपनी मंजिल को प्राप्त करना है. Creed of self-expression. English Romanticism was a creed, a religion of the expression of the self. The classicism preached that personal aspects of the mind should not be expressed, but romantic artistic, but the self in the nature of their art. In other words, they represented their personal experience, view, idea, etc. in their artistic emotions. There the self of the writer stands invisible in the center and describes its experience, reaction, invention, etc. That is why such pronouns as I, my, we, us are present in the most literary creation up to 1830. Creed of all embracing art. English Romanticism was a creed of all embracing art. It embraces all forms of poetry, whether classical or romantic, so experience with all kinds of meter and prosody. They employed in the elements of rhetoric. They enriched their language with words of their age and every level of society. तो जो शब्दों का प्रयोग किया गया वो साधारण शब्दों का प्रयोग किया गया, डिफिकल्ट शब्दों का प्रयोग नहीं किया गया. सो डिफिकल्ट शब्दों का प्रयोग उन्होंने नहीं किया. They used a very simple diction. The poetic diction used by them was very simple. It was not the difficult. love of romantic beauty. What we know very well that it has been defined that poetry is an addition of strangeness to beauty. English romanticism excited great love for romantic beauty and also called wonder. The romantics sought it in nature, in the supernatural, in the past, in the mind, or in the imagination. English romanticism excited great love for romantic beauty, also called wonder. The romantics sought it in nature. Prakriti mein unhone dhoondne ki koshish ki. In supernatural, Paramatma mein unhone dhoondne ki koshish ki. In the past, in the mind, or in the imagination. The two prose writers and critics of the times of the Hazlitt and Charles Lamb, they sought romantic beauty in Elizabethan literature and created it in their prose. Sir Walter Scott is the novelist of this period. He sought romantic beauty in the past and expressed in the novels. So according to Watts Dunton, the romantic revival was the renaissance of wonder. So what is the definitions of romanticism? The romanticism is the renaissance of wonder. The romantics discovered wonder and represented in their prose, in their poetry, in their novel, etc. Their imagination excited, imagination, visions, which produced intense emotions. Their sensibility employed images and represented their experience in literary art of universal nature. The experience thus represented is highly striking, pleasant, and picturesque. So, my dear student, we have understood what is romanticism. Romanticism is an addition of strangeness to beauty. Romanticism is a renaissance in wonder. And we have already discussed about the characteristics of the romanticism. I may ask you the question that what do you mean by romanticism? Define romanticism. Write any 4 or 5 salient features of romanticism. What do you think about the romantic era? Describe or discuss in your own words. So please prepare these questions and learn the socio-economic, moral and cultural values of 19th century Great Britain, and then prepare your notes. Thank you very much for the day. Thanks a lot to all of you. Bahut bahut dhanyawad.